So I'm going to switch to my environment, and I'm going to show you how to actually get started with serverless functions. And I have here an instance of VS Code. It's an empty one. And the first thing that you need to know as you're getting started with Azure Functions is that you need to create a function app. And in order to do that, you need to have this incredible extension that's called Azure Functions. If you haven't installed it already, please just stop what you're doing. Go ahead and install this extension. It's going to save your life in so many ways. I already have it installed. I'm going to go into the Azure extension here in VS Code, and I'm going to create a new function app. And a function app is basically a collection of our serverless functions or cloud functions. And I can create this function in Python, JavaScript, TypeScript, C Sharp, or Java, depending on what's your preference for writing code. For this one in particular, I'm going to use Python, but I'm a huge fan of JavaScript and TypeScript as well. We're going to use Python 3 for our serverless function, and we're going to create an HTTP trigger because remember, we want to create an API. And let's name this generate joke. And in case I haven't mentioned this before, I'm creating this app to create competition for Seth and Donna, who are some of the funniest people I've ever encountered in my life. And when both of them are together, it's even better. So what we are going to do over the next 5 minutes is create an API that uses AI to generate jokes. So I have created a hello world function here, and I can go ahead and test. So before doing anything else, I always like testing my code, making sure that everything works as expected. So you can see here that our function runtime has started, and then this is the URL where I can already start making HTTP requests, and then I'm going to get back a response. So in this case, it says that I need to pass in a name, and let's say we want to say, "Hi, powerful devs, you are awesome, the absolute best of people." Okay, awesome. So our function works. I'm going to also add a breakpoint here, so maybe if I go refresh this page, we will see that we now have our debugger has stopped at line 10, and we can inspect our variables, and we can say that we can see that the name is powerful devs. And once I step through, then it's going to come back and show the hello powerful devs message, which is a great confirmation. Okay, but back to our humorous API. Let's go ahead and delete all this code, which we don't need. And the first thing that we're going to do is actually retrieve a model that I have already created using this library called TextGenRNN, which uses deep learning to take an existing data set of one-liner jokes. And then it creates a model, or it already created a model for me, which I'm hosting in blob storage. And based off of that model, I'm going to generate new jokes. Okay, let's do this. all right, so we have retrieved the model. Then the next thing that we want to do is actually generate these jokes. And I mentioned that we're doing that using TextGenRNN. So we're first reading the initializing TextGenRNN. Using the model we've just copied from blob storage, and then we're going to generate new jokes. And we're going to return those in a HTTP response that is a JSON object, contains a JSON object with a field joke and the actual joke. So let's go ahead and also say, define this HTTP response method, which allows us to format our JSON. And then, of course, we also need to import all of these dependencies that we are using in our code. And finally, I mentioned that we are using TextGenRNN. We have to go define those dependencies in requirements.txt as well. So I'm going to go into my cheat sheet here and copy these particular versions because these are the ones that currently work for me. Let me know if you try this and you find a version that works with all the latest versions. All right, so I'm going to run this application. And this will take a bit because now we have to install these dependencies, so Keras, TensorFlow, TextGen, RNN. And I want to tell you the story behind this application. So that happened back in December. I built this application around that time. I published a post on Dev2 on it, explaining the solution. But there was one comment that has haunted me ever since, where someone has asked, hey, is this application running live somewhere? Can I test it? Of course, I have published the GitHub repository, but I haven't gone through the process of actually creating a web application that allows you to see these randomly generated jokes. And the reason why I haven't done that, if you're a web developer and you know how many choices we currently have, and you've seen the diagram that Chris on Code has shared with all of us, you will know that many times we end up dropping projects. So with this new Power Apps platform, I thought that, hey, this is my chance to try Power Apps and see how cool it is and how fast it empowers me to create applications. So, all right, our function app has started, is available in our local environment. So if I click on the link that has been generated, we should now have the funniest joke ever, I promise. Of course, we're now stopping at the breakpoint we put earlier. I'm going to run through this and then going back into our browser. The funniest joke ever is, what do people is the balloon and the fence only talking? It is two hands. All right, this is random. So we've seen how to create a function app in our local. We've seen how to run and debug it here. But ideally, we want to have this application deployed in the cloud so we can use it in our Power App. So I'm going to stop debugging this. And then I'm going to go back into the Azure extension. And this is where we're deploying the application. And the first thing that's going to ask me is the name of the function app or whether I want to deploy over an existing app. So let's say we want to name this generate jokes, and this is a unique name that needs to be created. I want to use Python and deploy to UK South, which is where I'm currently located. Now, I've already deployed this app before, spoiler alert. So instead of waiting for our deployment to happen, we're actually going to go and check out this other Jokes API that I've deployed earlier. And we can see here that is currently working at the jokesapi.azurewebsites.net. If you want to try this yourself, it's available at aka.ms/joke. So very simple. Check it out. Tweet all the jokes that get generated for you. I'm sure they're going to be really good ones.